Students, in this class we are going to discuss the fifth chapter of Flamingo. It's very important chapter because questions are asked every year from this chapter. In this chapter, you will have to study Indian history. You have to study about Indian National Congress. You have to know about the Indian struggle for freedom. A literature student or one who studies literature must have to keep in mind almost all the subjects in one way or the other. If you remember, in chapter number 1, we had studied world history, the history of France and Germany. In the third chapter, we had studied about physics. In the chapter Deep Water, we had studied the Newton's third law of motion, that every action has equal and opposite reaction. In chapter number 4, you have studied philosophy of life, that this whole world is nothing but a big rat trap. And in this chapter 5, we are going to discuss about Indian history, the struggle for freedom, about our great leaders, and how India started under the leadership of Mahatma Gandhi, the freedom struggle, the freedom movements. In this chapter, we find a character, very simple. His name is Rajkumar Shukla. While studying the chapters, you must know about the characters of that particular chapter. Because unless and until you have the knowledge of the character, you have the idea of the character, you cannot answer perfectly. The answers will mix up. So you must know about the characters, that which characters belong to which chapters, you must keep in mind. You also have to know about the writers or the authors of every chapter. So chapter number 5, Indigo, has been written by Louis Fisher. The spelling is L-O-U-I-S, but it's not pronounced as Louis. It's Louis Fisher, F-I-S-C-H-E-R. So don't put stress that if the spelling is F-I-S-H, fish, E-R-R, Fisher. No, it's not. It will become wrong. So write correct spelling in English literature. Otherwise, you will lose the marks. The spelling of Fisher, you have to write as F-I-S-C-H-E-R. Fisher. So Louis Fisher is the writer of this short story, Flamingo. Chapter number 5, Indigo. Rajkumar Shukla, a tenant. Do you know the meaning of tenant? T-E-N-A-N-T, tenant. Tenant is equal to landless farmer. Landless farmer is equal to sharecropper. Sharecropper is equal to one who works on others field and earn crops, not in all the share, but he just take half the share. And the half of the share goes to the landowner, the big landlords or the big farmers whose land is there, and on whose land the landless laborer or the landless farmer or the tenant or the sharecropper works. Now I hope you have come to know the meaning of tenant, T-E-N-A-N-T. Nowadays In post-post modern era, we use the word tenant for a renter, whom we have rented our flat or our home. They are called tenant. But in this chapter, chapter number 5, tenant means landless farmer who works on the land of or farms of or fields of other farmers. So Rajkumar Shukla is one of them. He doesn't have his own land, but he has taken the land on rent to cultivate crops. And British landlords used to give the farms to the Indian farmers at that point of time. In this chapter, you have to know about Gandhiji's arrival to India. After practicing in South Africa for many years, he returned to India on 9th January 1915. And that day is celebrated, 9th January is celebrated as NRI Day every year in India. NRI Day means non-residential Indian Day in India every year. 9th January is celebrated like that. Because Gandhiji came back on this day from South Africa to India. Rajkumar Shukla was told by someone that Gandhiji is a very unique, helpful and supportive personality. If you bring any problem towards him, he will solve it in no time. There was the landlord system. In that system, the Indian landless farmers, Indians tenants, used to take land on rent. And as per the arrangement or agreement, 3/20th part of the crops will be taken by the British landlords. 3/20th or 15% crops. If you convert 3/20th into percentage, you know how to convert it. 3/20 into 100, you will get 15%. British landlords used to compel the Indian farmers, the landless farmers, the tenants, to grow crops on 15% land, 15% farms. And what crop was grown on that 15% land? It was indigo. British landlords compels the Indian farmers to grow indigo in the 15% or 3/20th part of their land, and that will be taken as rent by them. They didn't take cash as rent, but they used to acquire indigo as rent. The indigo which was grown on 3/20th or 15% land. In the meantime, Germany has developed synthetic indigo. And the distance between Germany and Britain is very less. And the distance from India to Britain is very much. So Britishers started exporting. They started telling Indian farmers that we won't take your indigo. We are setting you free from the 15% or 3/20th arrangement of land. Now you have to pay rent in cash we are not going to take indigo from you people. And one point is to be noted here, that the land on which indigo is grown, the land becomes infertile forever and ever and ever. No crops, even the grass, cannot grow on that piece of land on which indigo is cultivated. So those farmers who didn't know about Britain policies, that it's going to take indigo, it's going to import indigo from Germany, they paid the rent in cash. And other farmers who knew the fact that the British landlords stopped importing indigo from India because they are importing it from Germany. So Rajkumar Shukla is one of them. Earlier, he used to pay the rent in the form of indigo. But after the removal of the first agreement, the farmers will have to pay in cash, and their land, they became infertile. So this injustice was not digested by Rajkumar Shukla and many farmers across India. They felt as if they had been cheated by the British landlords. So someone had told Rajkumar Shukla to go to Mahatma Gandhi, to meet him and to tell him the problem. And those days, in 1916-1915, Congress has organized National Convention every year. Means all the people belonging to Congress Party used to meet in one place. In any one of the districts, in one of the states of India. That was called Indian National Congress Annual Convention. And in that annual convention, Rajkumar Shukla meets Mahatma Gandhi. It was the convention of Lucknow in 1916. If you Google it, if you check it in books, history books, you will find that in 1916, Congress has called its convention in Lucknow. Got it? So there, Rajkumar Shukla meets